The pressure cooker is actually a part of the bomb. So to clarify that, it's one of the components. How difficult to do, the instructions obviously are out there on if you Google pressure cooker IEDs, unfortunately, it's up there. It tells us it's somebody who's somewhat savvy that may be able to put together the components of an IED and create an explosive device. So they've taken an improvised common everyday items to build a bomb.
And does it say anything about the person who carried out the attack?
Well, they had some degree of sophistication or education in that it actually worked. And I think this is the first actual bombing that's been successful in the United States since 9/11. So they were able to do that. That says something. They defeated security measures.
It doesn't say if it's domestic or foreign, though.
It does not.
When you look at the explosive charge here, I don't want to get too much into the details, but how does the explosive charge actually work? Because I read that when it does go off, the actual force looks for the path of least resistance in all of this.
Right. In this case, this isn't really a targeted device. This is just a general explosion with what appears to be, from the video, a low explosive. So there's a lot of fire, a lot of flash, but not as much blast effect or force. But it just the explosive force expands out. That pressure vessel expands as well, and actually, as it fails, it contributes to the blast effect by creating fragmentation, or frag as commonly known, shrapnel.
And what about where the bombs were actually placed? Assuming that photograph we've seen of the backpack was actually one of the bombs, what do you make of that?
Well, I think you're referencing that there's a photograph out there on the web there's a brownish bag that seems to be placed on the outside of a personnel barrier towards the street. That appears to have, it would have been suspicious, I think, to most people, so it would question how long it's been there. But judging if that is in case the bomb, which we don't know if it is, the blast goes back into the crowd. So it seems very clearly that they were targeting the pedestrian crowd. And that would be consistent with what the reports are of what's been the nature of the injuries. The nature of the injuries contain a lot of fragmentation, shrapnel, I've heard reports of nails, ball bearings, BBs. Plus, you're going to get the metal of that. The vessel from the pressure cooker expanding as well.
You're also worried about the amount of publicity which these pressure cooker bombs have now received.
I am. I'm also, it's been interesting that there's been so much attention given to every little piece of evidence, or it appears that way to the viewer. We don't want to do anything in these situations that would in any way contribute to someone conducting other attacks and being successful and getting away with it. So. Plus the publicity, there's always the threat of copycats. So it would be best if these things take time. The ATF, the FBI are the best in the world. They've trained all over the world. They're going to reconstruct that scene with a post-blast analysis. They're going to reconstruct that device so that they know exactly what happened, where those pieces came from, and they're going to build a lot of evidence towards a case out of that. Everybody needs to take a deep breath. It's going to take a little time.
One other thing, too, is that the Department of Homeland Security has been warning for quite some time about these pressure cooker bombs. I mean, this is a warning which was issued in 2004.
Right, 2004. As I referenced, I think there's another one in 2010. I believe they really first came on the scene in Iraq. It's a very common appliance in Iraq and in the Middle East. We've seen them in Afghanistan. And it's six-quart. It's very handy to place in a large amount of explosives and shrapnel. And it's easy to convert into some type of device.